trying to pick it back up. He lost a lot of time. They gave the goal line for the chance to come down the field.
42-32, 14 seconds to go in the third quarter, and it's the Longhorns who have made the play in the second half, starting with an incredible drive to open the third quarter that was highlighted with a 33-yard pass from Jim Cosia to Jeremy Jackson. But let's see what Winharrow has to say about this. They've got a first and 15, snap back to Lopez. Looking for a receiver, he has one at the 15. He's tackled there at the 20. Wonderful open field tackle there. Let's see who comes up from that one. Number 33, Jeremy Jackson, with a wonderful open field tackle. In fact, he made his save to touchdown there. That's how wide open that receiver was after he caught the football. Picks up about 10 yards, 9 yards, and that is the end of the third quarter. 42-32, second and 6, Lopez pitches back. And in trouble is number 20 for Whitney on. He is going to be stopped. Tony Segura, who's had a good day today, but he's down to the 20-yard line after he picks up about 2 yards. And that's going to bring up a third down. And you can listen for the crowd on this next play. You will hear their approval if the Longhorns somehow manage to stop Winharrow on this one.
Terrell on a play of just 1 yard. He had a pretty good quarter back, 3-22.
Now Winharrow has a second down, a third down on the situation. Six-man championship for Sweetwater. Lopez pitches back to Rogers. Rogers wants to throw the ball. He's in trouble. Dumps it off. It's incomplete.
Lots of time left of the ball.
That does stop the clock with 9 minutes, 16 seconds to go in the fourth quarter, and it's decision time with Harold. They've got fourth and about 6 yards. They're fairly deep in their own territory at the 20-yard line. And do you punt the ball into this wind, which is apparently what they're going to do, or do you go for it? Brandon Rogers is back in punt formation, but I'm sure with the option to run for it, if he thinks he can get it, it's a fake punt, and Rogers has the ball, and Cosia has a chance to punt it. He's got it right there. Oh, my goodness. That's a huge play. He's a foot into the down. He's going to get the football, and about the 24-yard line. You cannot have a better situation than that. You really can't. That is big, and that was a well-engineered snap to one of the short men who pitched it back to Rogers. Rogers took off around the left side. That, my friends, is big, because as Brett says, the Longhorns get the ball at the 23-yard line. Incidentally, they stopped Rogers about a yard and a half short of the first down. And here with new life is the Gore Longhorns. There's a handoff to 5-4 up the middle. Oh, and he had a big hole. It collapsed very quickly as he crossed the 20-yard line. He's knocked down at the 19 after he picked up about 4. And there is electricity here in the air, and these Gordon Longhorn fans find it hard to sit down. In fact, many of them are not sitting down right now. 8 minutes, 50 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. The Longhorns are down by 10 points, but they have come back to life from the second half. They're threatening inside the 20-yard line. Lucia pitches it back inside, or he wants to throw the ball, has the receiver open, and he ends up in the end. Defensive interference on Winharrow in the end zone. And I thought that ball was just a little bit behind the man. Might have been a touchdown. You've got to remember, this is for all of us, folks, for the state championship. Winharrow won one in 1981. Green has never won one. And this is what they start for right way back in Tulane, long time ago. First and goal from the 9-yard line in the tight formation with 9 more for Arena in the backfield. Handoff, quick hitter up the middle to Tom Arena, who finds the football. And let's see who came up with it. Gordon comes up with it. John Levin just saved the day. John Levin just made a few extra yards. He got that football down the field. I mean, the ball now up on the 40-yard line. You guys were going to be on the 5 and on the same thing. But it's a huge break. Of course, a huge break. You're right. It's not a planned thing. And Tom Arena fumbled the ball as he was hit at the 5. But Levin saved the day, my friend. Inside the 3-yard line, closer to the 2. Cosia off the right side, the side is on the side, and Robin, he's in! Jim Cosia looking to use John Levitan again, powering through the line of scrimmage. Beautiful play for the Gordon Longhorns. And if you don't think the crowd isn't back in this ball game, if you don't think the Gordon Longhorns Duff, you are not here. This stadium just erupted in approval as Jason Sizemore goes in with the second and third effort and falls across the goal line. Now he'll try to attempt the point after. The snap is bad, a hold, and it's lost again. But it really doesn't make too much difference at this point unless you're thinking field goal as the game goes on. But in any case, it's a big fourth quarter, fourth down stand for the Longhorns. They get the ball and go into the end zone. 7 minutes, 54 seconds to go. We have got a barn burner here in Sweetwater, Texas. First and 15 for Whitfield as they get the ball at the 20-yard line. There's a pitch back to Rogers. He's trying to find some room. He has some room. Breaks out of one tackle and knocks out of bounds at the 29-yard line. I guess he's okay. Apparently so. He high-stepped over Jeremy Jackson back behind the line of scrimmage and managed to pick up, about 9 yards. So it's going to bring up second and six, and I would be willing to bet that Whitfield is not dead yet. Not even close. 42-38. Second and left ball at about six from the 29-yard line. There's a snapback and a pitchback to Lopez, who makes the move and now is up in the field and picks up about five. Ran into some problems behind the line of scrimmage, but came up and made a good move. And now we got one of the Longhorns who's injured. Looks like an ankle. That's number 15 for Gordon. Shannon St. Clair, 200-pound junior. And he's being helped off the field right now. That looks like it's definitely an ankle. I don't think he'll be back. Boy, he is really hurting on that left leg. Really hurt. Aren't too bad for him, to be sure. Third and one for Whitmer. Ball is inside the 35. Quarterback is Lopez. Long down, handoff up the middle, and Gordon made his stop there short of the first down. It was a quick hitter off the left side. They only had to pick up about 2 feet, and they did. They stopped him short. It's going to be fourth and a foot. I tell you what, Lynn, if I win here, I can work right now. On fourth half momentum, I don't want to be disastrous, but they did make it. But hey, if you give Gordon the chance to come back on you right now,
Rogers, that's Steph Dockery, who is going to be stopped short